some of the tips. I think as I'm discussing this, I think I'll be relating with some of the things that we've done before and stuff. So that I don't need to talk more about the aim of but major thing that prompts this is to conduct applied research and innovation by academics in a public tertiary institution in Nigeria. And the major purpose is to drive high quality manpower to address many of this nation, our nation economy and development. This is what started in 2009. And then as of like this year now, we have 7.5 billion approved for this year. I think it's increasing day by day. Like if you can check from a table we have here, we discovered that from when they started issuing out this call with like 2012, we have like 13 that have been approved. Or compare it to what you take in 2019, we have like 128, which is good. So I want to believe that this year also. But I think there's a paradigm shift last year on the issue of people are not able to thorough, they are not thorough enough, the assessors are not thorough enough because of the volume of the proposal they receive. So that's why the issue of consent note come. Though just like 1,500 words, which is very easy for them to go through. So from there, they step it down. You can see from about, I think about 2,855 that was submitted last year. Only 106 made it to full proposal, which is good enough for them to, at least to manage. And out of this, we have 128. So these are the things. So Dr. Ajayi has talked about the thematic. I think it's very, very good for us to start with, to understand the thematic we are working in. First, we think about the category. Like we said, we have the humanity and social science. For some of us that fall into that line, please let's look at this. Another one is science, education, and technology. This is the area I belong to. So please, let's look at it. We have some thematic area there that work. It's okay. The reason for this is that to be able to identify a good reviewer that can review your work. If you have a good idea and not sent to a good reviewer, they can as well trash your documents. So it's better to check it where there are some that interlap. That's what this is, cross-cutting. One of the things that is like last year, some of the one I applied for, because I'm from engineering background, I think from thematic B, and that's a category B. But this time I discovered that they added about two or three. That is very, very important, especially in SDG. I want to tell you, sir, Amma, if you are doing a research that related to SDG, you have more chance of getting it. Because a lot of people have been talking about this SDG, that the goal 17, goal 1, goal whatever. Specifically, in my whole area, I work with goal 7. That is clean energy, available energy, which is goal 6 in cross-cutting. So please, let's take our time to look at this well before we apply, so that our document can get to a good reviewer and they will review. Just like you said, some of the procedure I've mentioned before is the call for consent. This will take them to the sorting into different thematic, so that they can identify a good reviewer that can review this document. And if it is successful, they call for the full proposal. After the full proposal being called for, the screening and evaluation committee have to sit down to look at what is the article, what is the review comments from different reviewers they send this work for. If it is worth funding, they call for the defense. Last year, my peer and myself, we went for one of these, and it's very, very interesting, because most of the things that you quoted in your document, they want to verify, is it true? Especially is on the issue of budget. I like to come again with this. I remember our moderator was saying the other time that he discovered that the most of the budget that was with and won is limited. Yes, it's limited, but initially some of take it high. But by the time we get to that table of defense, you'll be able to say, okay, this is good, this is not good, and then they can appropriate the fund that will be suitable for the work. So from there, we have a recommendation to be selected by the Board of Trustees of NRA committee, and then leading to the award of the grant vendor. Some of the eligibility that some of us have read in the court notice for the year is that, well, we must be a lecturer in a tertiary institution, must be in polytechnic, must be or in college of education, and the PI must be institutional based. Unlike in the UK, that they give most of the PI is the industry coming or whatever, but this time around, for them to be able to monitor the fund, you have to be one institutional based, so that your first chancellor, everybody will be able to monitor. If you have a research unit, you'll be able to monitor how you are spending fund, because this is a government money, a public fund. Another thing, it must be organized department or funded department. Another point here is that the research must be inter. That's, I want to really emphasize much on this. If you are having, yeah, people are talking of concepts, I may have an idea that is towards solar electrical engineering, because that's my field. But I will still look what are the area that other people can contribute. So I can bring someone that come from ICT, information technology. I can bring someone that come from even from engineering, I mean renewable energy. There are some of these things that can contribute. I tell you that one of the things was that the components they give for teamwork is very, very, very high. This is that they want to see how you distribute the discipline. So taking, if you are a PI and every other PI are from your department, you have less chance of winning. That is it. So looking around, which area can this guy contribute, either in this idea and this idea, is very, very important. Another point there is that the investment must be, this year specifically, please let's take note of that. For some of us that are not yet a professor, we'll be looking upward now to see who we can partner with. Because now, this year, we can see how the world. They say it must be preferably professorial cadet for people in higher institutions. I mean, what in the university system. Please, last year, yeah, from senior lecturer and above. I don't think it to senior lecturer this year, but for them to have said it, it's preferably professorial cadet. So you can look for a professor that is fast in that field, either in your school or whatever, so that we can work together. So, like I said, preparation is very, very important in anything that we are doing. Dr. Ajay said, we have one full month to prepare our concept note. So we need a very well prepared, thoughtful plan and concise package because of the money that's involved. It's not a trash they are talking about there. So something like this. So effective preparation are very, very important. I will jump some of this. So in concept note, the major expectation of what you need to focus on when you are writing a concept note is that we must be able to present the problem that we have, that we focus on in different, thematic area. Like I said, we have each of the thematic on different category. If you, there's this NRF brief that was attached to the TED Fund website. If you go through that document where there are research focus on under each thematic. Looking at those focus will help you in fine-tuning your work towards that area. So it's very, very important. Secondly, we must describe our objective. The project objective is very important. We'll talk more about that. We need to describe the group that will benefit from it. You're talking about the impact now. What are the group that will benefit? Is it academia will benefit? Is it people in private sector will benefit? So it's very, very important. Just like I said, in one of the one that won, we know people that in all of that, they will really, really benefit from it. Secondly, people of the host community also will benefit because everybody has seen the impact of all this vandalization, breakage in the pipeline, whatever, supply, whatever like that. Another point yet I want to know also is that we must discuss the expected results. What are those things we are expecting to see? I think it's very, very important for us to talk about that. Also, we must describe the types and activities that are planned. That is talking about the timeline. We have our timeline. What are those activities? For this also month, for this whole, so all these are very, very important. We look at some of the criteria they are looking for in concept notes according to TED Fund. One is that the research must be novel, it must be significant. If it's not significant, it cannot be funded, as many of us have known about that. Potential scientific breakthrough is very, very important. What is the breakthrough? A lot of people have been working in the area we have been working, but what is the niche? Can we carve out of it? It's very, very important. So the breakthrough. Out of it, what is the new thing? That's why there's a session. They talk about the new things. What is the new thing you are asked? So please, prove, look for an inch that your work, your research can contribute to the previous result that been done. The technical team competence is very important too. The competence of the technical, like I say, I will still show us, we have 10 points. That the, out of the 100 points is 10 points they give for the team. So in this technical team, you have to get the people, the right people that will do the needful. It's just not adding the name of this person, adding the name of this person. Another thing in that technical team is that they are expecting us to provide a means of training our students. What is the impact of our work on our students? Employing an RA from our student, you have undergrad student, you have postgrad student that can work. So what I'm trying to bring up is mentoring is very vital. So they are looking at how do we mentor. That mentoring statement is very, very important by adding some of the name of our undergraduate or postgraduate student that can work either in the field. Another point is that, the relevance to the goals, I'll talk about that. How is your topic relevance, or how is your area relevant to that thematic area? by the time you go through that NRF brief I'm talking about, and the budget, how realistic, especially that's why you said when they call for that meeting, what do you call it, they want to say how realistic. It's not just giving, I want to buy this, I want to. So you have to do what? With good justification. So I just want to give some of the tips, top tips for writing concept notes. One of these is that based on different sections, you have that title, background, whatever. Just like Dr. Ajay has talked about, he has explained this about 20 words. Or some of them, maybe they are not there, but that's it. It must not be one more than 20. This is that instruction. Just following what they require, it helps us a lot. The title also must reflect the context. If not reflecting the content, that means as long as it is not good. So another thing is that on the background, in the background, you must be able to define what the problem we are solving. You must be able to justify, yeah, there's a problem. People have been suffering. You need to justify why you want to conduct your own research in order to see that that problem has solved. And especially, those problems must be linked to developmental need of a nation. Especially, we focus more on Nigeria. How do we develop our country in different areas? That's why I'm talking about this SDG. For some of us that have opportunity, please let's check this goal, the 17 goals. You can pick from each of these and that will really help us. Problem statement, you will be able to state it to address the research project we are trying to solve, which will lead to the research question. In that research question will lead to what is the objective. And objective, one of the things that we are learning to do is that we must make sure that we summarize both the long term and the short term. Yeah. The program is just for 2 years. I mean, the timeline is just for 2 years. But there are some goals that can be achieved within less than 6 months. There are some goals that can be achieved more than 6 months. So please, be able to summarize and then be effective in the summarize. Another thing is that we must be clear, indicate clarity of the problem to the problem of the project in order to help to address it. And finally here is that let our objective be smart. When you're talking about the smart objective here, we are talking about it must be specific. It must be measurable, it must be achievable, it must be realistic, and it must be time-bound. These are things they look for. If the objective cannot be measured, it's as big as it cannot be funded. It must be what we can achieve within the 2 years they give to us. That's why the issue of the time-bound is coming up. A project that is more than 3 years may not be funded under this call. So that's why there's 2 years, but let it be project-bound. Talking about the literature review, all of us have known what we need to do in literature. The new things, and what are those things, area we can add in new things to. I think that's that. Another point here is that there's a session they talk about logical framework for the research. You have to define what is your research philosophy in that. What is your research approach? What's your research design? What's your research strategy? What is your data collection method? What is your data analysis? All these things need to be what effectively described. This will help the reviewer in know either the grant is fundable also. And also, this leads us to the method. We must define the approach proof method that we need. And since I talk about, yeah, the breakthrough must have a clear statement of the new thing that must be done, that your research tree to bring about. The impact, I talk about the social impact, what is the economic impact, what is the technological benefit of our research to the community or to the nation as a whole. So, and also you can name the beneficiary. Technical team, I think I've talked about this technical team. The detail of the member must be shown there. If it's a professor, what fit is that professor coming from? In related to the theme of your work. Another thing is that I said you have to provide a means for mentoring students, young researchers, because we are thinking that all we can leave the legacy down and all of them will be able to get from it. So the main point here is that the quality of the leadership. So that's why the head is very, very important, the PI. So the kind of person we are going to use as a PI must be trustworthy. Integrity, you must be able to provide the leadership. You must be able to conduct the team well. The potential for mushrooming will be there, that the team will. Yeah. I think budget also, we have different type of budget, whatever. So I will end with this. I had this major failure for the unsuccessful of last year proposal. If you can get that from that reserve, the tech fund has identified. One of it is that research scope is too broad. You need to bring it to what is on that planet. So the scope. And some of them is unfocused. It could not be connected with title and the content of the work we are doing. Another one is that the little originality in the research idea, if it must be no fair, it must be original. Another thing you are talking about here is that some of them are what poorly written executive summary. Maybe when next I have the time to talk again, I will talk majorly on this executive summary, because this is the first impression we have before the reviewer. So some people write their, so there are components we need to add to our executive summary to make it, you know, welcoming. Poorly stated objective, just like I said, some of the objectives are not smart enough. It's not measured, it's not specific, it's not time-bound or whatever. Another point here is that the complaint of unsatisfactory or inadequate methodology in addressing the area. So many of these professors that will review the award, they are granted in one of the areas, in one or two areas of this award. You'll be able to know the methodology, is it a quick method you have to use or latest method in time. Another thing, the choice of the tools we want to use in analyzing our data is very important. Another point is that inadequate or shallow research content, that you know, is still talking about the content of that research is not very low. Another, the last one is talking about outrageous budgeting. Just like the moderator has talked about, some of us just want to push into that 50 million. It's not necessary we put to, but I learned that it's at least half. Let's just work between that half and above. It may not be less than half because they know that, okay, this is the money they've already amount for this work, but from half and above. So, but what I'm saying is that, yeah, there's nothing that I'm not making to make your project, your fee have to be 50 million, but we must be able to justify it. Justify what you allocate for the personnel. Justify what you allocate for the equipment purchase. Justify what you use for travel. And all of them have a template. Like personnel should not be more than 20%. Equipment should not be more than 25%. Travel should not be more than 5% and so. But please, let me just stop here so that I can allow other parties to talk. Thank you.
Thank you so very much, Dr. Olatomiwa. I was wondering whether you are a teacher, but well, of course, lecturers are teachers. Thank you so very much. You've provided us an extensive gist, tips as regards what can be done. Can you just stop presenting? Can you stop your presentation? We might have got from what you said. You emphasize a lot on many things, like the issue of the fact that it has to be interdisciplinary. You talked about advanced, adequate preparation. You also emphasized a lot on the constitution, the composition of a team. And I think this